Hey, Benny Fash. 26th of December, 2020. Pray you all had a good holiday, albeit a pagan ritual. In my view, if your eyes are on Christ, then it's all good. We should be seeking his counsel every single day, walking in his spirit, not just one day a year. But I was putting together this video pertaining to the financial system. There are so many things adding up that just point to a complete reset of the finances and a slide into the digital blockchains of darkness system. It is coming. We all know that that is coming. But as I'm preparing this, yesterday I come across a video of Benjamin Netanyahu pandering to Christians. And he's talking about his Christian friends and how much he loves them and all these things. And literally within hours after making this announcement, he launches airstrikes on Syria, which is a largely Christian nation. So the hypocrisy that we see, not just with Israel, but all of them, there is not a single president, prime minister, pope, priest, or pastor that's going to save anyone from anything. Nothing is going to rid this world of this dark wickedness but the blood of Jesus Christ. Period. So I put together this piece just pointing out the hypocrisy for educational and inclusivity purposes. I'm going to share these things with you. So take it for what it's worth. Praise Jesus every day because he is the Savior of the world. And God bless you all. And peace and grace to you. Many fish.
I wish Israel's many Christian friends around the world a very Merry Christmas. On behalf of the people of Israel, I thank each and every one of you for your prayers and for your support.
Allah.
This Christmas, the traditional greeting of peace on earth will once again be expressed by millions across the globe.
Allah.
This while our world suffers from the terrible COVID-19 pandemic.
We're in a live exercise here.
And far from too much violence and conflict. But remarkably, here in the Middle East, we've been actively making progress in realizing the biblical prophecy of peace on earth, or at least this part of the earth.
Allah.
This past year, and with the active help of the United States and President Trump,
somebody had to do it. I am the chosen one.
We have moved forward with the Abraham Accords, achieving historic breakthroughs between Israel and the Arab world. Peace with the United Arab Emirates, peace with the Kingdom of Bahrain, peace with the Republic of Sudan, peace with the Kingdom of Morocco. After 26 years without a new peace treaty, we've had 4 new agreements in less than 4 months. And this is just the beginning. More and more Arab countries are rethinking traditional hostile attitudes towards Israel and are seeking reconciliation with the Jewish state. Instead of regarding Israel as their enemy, they increasingly regard us as a friend, as an ally, a vital ally and a vital partner. This is a new and revolutionary change. It will make a better life, a better place for all the peoples of the Middle East. It will make for a better world. And so this Christmas, when you pray for Israel and you pray for peace, know that your prayers are really being answered. Peace on earth. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
שלום, הגעתי מתוכנית ההיסטוריה של טופי והגורילה. הוא בא לדבר על מאורעות מרכזיים בקורות העם היהודי, מאז ועד היום. היום נלמד על צליבת ישו. שמעת על ישו?
הוא נשמע אדם נחמד.
לא, ישו היה אויב העם היהודי. הוא ניסה להפוך את כולנו לנוצרים. אף שישנם נוצרים טובים, ההתבוללות היא סכנה נוראית, המאיימת על שלום העם היהודי.
אני רוצה להתבולל!
אתה יודע בכלל מה זה להתבולל? זה לקיים יחסי מין עם גויה. זה לא דבר שלא אני ולא אתה רוצים, כמובן.
אני רוצה שהילדים שלי יאכלו טבלרון ויהיו גויים. משעמם לי כאן, טופי. אני רוצה לגור בשוויץ עם גויה ולאכול טבלרון כל היום.
טוב, שוקי. אם אתה כל כך אוהב את ישו, אז אתה תשחק את ישו. אני הוא יהודה ישקריות.
ואני ישו. אני רוצה שכולכם תהפכו לנוצרים, ותאכלו חזיר וטבלרון, ויהיה לכם כיף! אתם רוצים הצופים בבית?
בגלל זה אני אצלוב אותך. איך אתה מעז להטיף ליהודים התמימים?
אלוהים! למה עזבת אני?
אתה נאצי, ישו, אתה נאצי!
טופי! לא, טופי, אני מפחד! אני הלכתי על המים, אני הפכתי צרצרים לעוגה! לא! אני לא ישו! זו טעות! אני משה רבנו! אל תגיעי במסמרים, טופי, לא!
זה רק חלק, פחדן!
זה כואב! לא! או טופי! או אלוהים! לא!
Isaiah 53. Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows, and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs, and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. And he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death. Because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see of the travail of his soul, and shall be satisfied. By his knowledge shall my righteous servant justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore will I divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he hath poured out his soul unto death, and he was numbered with the transgressors. And he bare the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors.
Thank you.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,